Okay, good afternoon, everyone. So what we are going to do in this session particularly, first of all, I'm going to kind of spend maybe half an hour discussing the properly constrained, improperly constrained, and partially constrained truss, because we have done already truss yesterday. And only thing that we have kept in mind that truss is statically determinate and properly constrained, therefore we are able to solve all the forces, okay? Now what we do here also, just to give the students a bit flavor that when truss can go actually unstable. So that is what we are now going to discuss. So remember that for the truss to be properly constrained, first of all, it should be able to stay in equilibrium for any combination of loading. And not only that, both the global equilibrium as well as internal equilibrium will be satisfied, okay? So what we have said yesterday, that we have a simple truss, let's say, and simple truss is always internally rigid. So it cannot deform or undergo rigid body motion inside of it, right? Now, when it is resting on support, we have to make sure that support is appropriately given. That means at least we need more than three supports. For a simple truss, we need three supports to balance it. But those supports has to be properly given. It has to be properly constrained such that no motion is allowed. So that is in terms of global equilibrium, okay? Now, there could be trusses where also it can have internal instability, and that is also possible. So what it means is that, let's say I have M plus R equals to 2N, but it is still possible that the truss is not stable, okay? However, if M plus R is less than 2N, then we can always say that the truss is unstable. So we call in that time that truss is partially constrained. So M plus R less than 2N, that means it is never going to satisfy the equilibrium conditions, and therefore it will be partially constrained, okay? And when M plus R is equals to or greater than 2N, there is also a possibility that truss is unstable. In that case, we will just say it is improperly constrained. Now remember one thing, that both partially constrained and improperly constrained cannot be classified as statically determinate or indeterminate, because in both cases, truss is unstable. We cannot say now it's a statically determinate or it's a statically indeterminate. When we say it's a partially constrained or it's a improperly constrained. So as I said, that M plus R equals to 2N is just a thumb rule to make sure, okay, can I start thinking about that it's a statically determinate truss? But it is not necessary, but it is not a sufficient condition that the truss has to be a stable truss, okay? So we'll now just, kind of continue various problems here. So first, let's look at these examples. So I have two examples here. And the main intention of these two problems are just to bring out, the essence that a simple truss can also be unstable, externally unstable, okay? So what has been done here in the first problem, as we see, it's a simple truss, but we have put it in two rollers. That means what happens? I need to have at least three supports. That is absolutely missing here. So we have two supports. That means sum of force along x equals to 0 is not balanced. Therefore, it's a unstable truss. And not only that, as we can see that m plus r equals to 2n, if I go by that logic, then in this case, m plus r is actually less than 2n. Okay. So it is a partially constrained truss, although it's a simple truss, but it is not supported properly. That means there is a inadequacy in the external constraints. There is no problem internally, but still the truss can collapse. So this will be called partially constrained, but that partial constraint is coming from the external side, not the internal side of the truss. Okay? In the second problem, now this is also a simple truss, and simple truss I only have three reactions. So one would think that this is also a stable truss, because in this case M plus R is indeed equals to 2N. But remember what will happen again, what is missing in this case? Once I apply the load, you know, like this in an inclined manner, then I am unable to balance this truss in the x direction, right? So M plus R is still equals to 2N, but it's an improperly constrained truss. So the point is M plus R is 2N, that is just a thumb rule. If M plus R is less than 2N, it is definitely a partially constraint, it will always collapse. If M plus R equals to 2N, it is not necessary that it's a stable truss, it can still collapse, but we will call it improperly constrained. Okay? So just let's do some exercise right now. Very simple exercises we will be doing. So all we have to answer that whether this truss is partially constrained, fully constrained, or improperly constrained. So let's go with the, you know, some counting from the very beginning. So how about the first one? It is fully constrained, right? Properly constrained. Why? Because I have a simple truss here at the very first case. And simple truss is supported by three proper reactions, because this reaction now, AX reaction, can absorb this type of force also, right? So in the AX direction, it can also be balanced in the X direction. So the first answer is that it's a properly constrained truss, and also we can solve all of these member forces, therefore it's a statically determinate as well. So how about the second one? Second one is partially constrained. Okay. Why? Because I have taken out this right member here. Now what happens to the truss? That is important. Now again, we have to kind of, you know, refresh our memory on method of sections and method of joints very quickly to analyze this kind of truss. Do I actually have internal equilibrium or not? Okay. So in this case, what happens? We can, if we just quickly go by the method of joints, what happens? This member is under compression. Now I just use a method of section instantly. So I will cut the truss here. If this member is in compression, then how the force will act on this part of the body? It will be? No, it is towards the joint if it's in compression, right? Now this part is a simple truss, no issue. This part is a simple truss, but I am going to apply a compressive force here that is coming through the member. And once I do the moment balance about this point at the left joint, then nothing is going to happen, right? I mean, what is going to happen? There is no moment balance about that point, because what is happening now, it's a contradictory in nature, because I am telling this member is a compression, right? Now if I apply this compression, it is now telling that moment about A should give me this force equals to zero, but that did not happen. That means if that force actually presents, right? That means it can actually turn the truss about the left hinge, left pin connection, okay? Therefore, the truss will deform. See, thinking from the point of view of equilibrium or forces is very easy than that of actually kinematic deformation. How the kinematic deformation is taking place, that is always complex, and you have observed that in the friction problem also. But if you can just remember from the force concept, it is always easy. I have always number of equilibrium equations must be satisfied. You know, number of unknowns should be number of equilibrium equations. Okay. So now that is not happening in this case. So this is my partially constrained truss. Now how about this one? This is not partially, just be careful. Here I have added one this member. So that means here I had taken it out, again I put it back here. So it is actually has to be said that m plus r still equals to 2n, but it is not stable truss. Same logic applies as that of before. Okay, so it will be called improperly constrained. Just the difference in name, partially and improperly. Okay. Now how about this? Just understand first that do we have a simple truss hidden here? Which portion of the truss is simple truss? From here up to here, it's a simple truss, right? So if I apply a method of section right here, that simple truss is properly supported by a pin support and by a roller support. That means I have actually three reactions properly pressed. That means no matter what happens, no matter how I apply the load on that portion of the truss, it is always going to sustain the load. So what I have to now worry about, okay, what happens to right here this member as I apply the method of section? This is also a rigid body, just a straight line, vertical member. It is supported by a roller and it is supported by, you can say the two forces are actually coming from this. But remember, in this case, no matter how you apply the loading, this part will also be stable. Okay? No matter how you apply the loading. So this will be completely constrained, that means properly constrained truss. Okay? So we understand the concept basically from the simple truss. Wherever I have simple truss, I am just going to keep that. Okay, and if that is properly constrained, then I can say that, okay, that part is properly constrained, then I look at the other part. Any question? Yes.
If I cut the section as you say, then from right hand side, again, if you take the moment about that joint, then there is no force to balance that moment.
Which one?
Right side. Right support.
This one, no? If I use method of section and we are looking at this side, now for this force, what is happening? It is just going to the support, right?
Top member?
Top member is zero. Top member is a zero force member as per the method of joint for this loading. Now you can incline the loading. That means you can just put a horizontal load. So what happens? This member will go to zero now. This member will go to zero. If we put a horizontal loading, this member will be zero. If this we take out, let's say we put a horizontal force, then this member will be zero, right? And ultimately force will be transferred here, but this part is stable. Okay, so any combination of loading therefore will hold good for this truss. Yes. Now, if you put an inclined load, na, then one force will be taken by this member and the other force will be taken by this member. There is no way you will be able to say that there is a non-equilibrium of that part. So sum of force along x0, sum of force along y0, sum of moment about a point has to be balanced, okay? Anywhere you take, even for that part. Now some part, you know, some forces may go to zero, some member forces, that is fine. It is coming from equilibrium though, okay? Yes. It is statically determined. That we have first said that count the number of members and number of unknowns, right? So I have number of member forces are 16, right? And number of reactions are 4, so total 20. And look at the number of joints we have, that is 10, so that is satisfied.
triangle.
Basic truss is triangle.
So that certainly is not valid here.
No, it is not, but it was not always true. Okay. It was not always true. What we have said also yesterday that we keep doing that extrusion, right? We keep extruding two members from the basic truss and we make the simple truss. Now here, what is the realization? That up to which point I have the simple truss.
Oh.
So if I can take that out, that simple truss I take out and make sure that that is properly balanced, then I go to the other part of it and try to analyze whether that is also properly balanced, no matter what kind of combination of loading I give.
But the complete truss is a truss, na?
Complete truss is a truss. Truss has no problem.
So that way then...
But I cannot call it the complete truss is not simple truss. Complete truss itself is not a simple truss.
But the equation m plus r equal to 2n is not satisfied, na?
Why? Count, na?
No, it is not satisfied. It is minus 1, na?
Why?
MR16.
There are four reactions. And number of forces are, number of members are 16. Okay. That is okay, that's fine. See, what we are analyzing here in this case, that it could be externally indeterminate, that is fine. But see, what is happening, that I have more than three supports, but question is whether that is solvable or not. It is solvable because I can use the equilibrium per joint. So I can establish 20, you know, equations and 20 unknowns. Is that clear? Okay.
Sir, one second. This truss is externally determinate.
This truss is both way determinate. Externally, no, externally determinate, yes, we cannot solve the all the reactions by taking the global equilibrium.
Yes,
but
sir.
Then you can go to the joint, you know, method of joints, you can still find the forces. So it is not, it is not a good idea to look into even that manner. External, what is externally? I am trying to analyze that whether the entire truss can be solvable or not. That's my objective.
Yes.
Right? Mm. Now there could be more than three supports, or there could be, you know, four supports, five supports, I don't care. What I care ultimately if I can find all the forces. Right? And that is fine, found here. Now let's look into this one. Very simple exercises. Quickly, because we should not take more time for this. Remember that there is a simple truss right here, simple truss right here. Again, you can think this of a compound truss. It is a good compound truss example, but what is happening here for that compound truss, I need six, right, unknowns. That is not happening because one side is a roller. One side needed to be hinged in order for it to be a compound truss, valid compound truss. Clear? So as soon as I apply the force in this case, and you can see clearly that it is going to actually go to this direction. Roller is going to move. So as a thumb rule, you can start doing this m plus r, you know, whether it is 2n or not. It is actually m plus r less than 2n. But logically, when we are applying, we can also try to look into, okay, we have learned the compound truss. Am I really getting a stable compound truss or not? It is not. Okay, so that means it's a unstable and partially constrained. So the answer is correct, okay? Now this one. I gave some hint here. How about M plus R, that concept? Do I have the number of, you know, unknowns equals to number of equilibrium equations? Now question is, okay, M plus R equals to 2N in this case. M plus R equals to 2N? So can I now say it's a statically determinate? And how do I prove, if it is, how do I show that it is a statically determinate or properly constrained? And if it is not, then how do I show it? So the basis is, let's say I do very quickly, you can try to look at, okay, we have already learned the method of joint. So let's say I look into this member. How about the force in this member? This is a tensile, right? So if this is tensile, if this force is tensile, then what is this force? That is also tensile, right? So therefore, BC is a tensile force. Question is, which part is actually a, you know, simple truss logic? If you look at this truss, right, internally it is stable, this portion of it, no issue. Internally it is stable. In fact, there is a redundancy here. There is an extra member, right? So up to this portion of the truss is properly, you know, internally stable. Now you apply that tensile force. So if I use method of section, there is a tensile force here acting, which is outward from joint B. Right? Then if I take a moment about again the left joint, what happens? It can rotate about that left joint. Right? That means equilibrium is not satisfied once I take a moment about that left joint. Clear? Therefore, it is a improperly constrained truss at the end. See, M plus R is still equals to 2N, but truss is not stable because it is violating the equilibrium about, you know, that left joint.
Excuse me, sir?
Yes.
Sir, suppose the P is upward.
Suppose P is upward. Does not matter. It has to be valid for any combination of loading.
The P on the left of B is suppose upward.
Fine. In one, see, if I want to make a truss stable, it has to hold good for any combination of loading. So if it fails in one combination of loading, I can say it's an unstable truss. So there is no way we can even discuss it further.
Okay.
Okay? Right? Because I have given you a loading for which it is failing, therefore no other questions comes into play. Is that clear? Because that is already failed. Huh? If it is, then that case it is okay, but it is violating the rule for the other combinations, right? Okay. It has to be stable for all combinations. Clear? Yeah, what was the issue? How it is supported, that cantilever truss?
With the help of vertical
but it
watch.
Has always two, four reactions at the one end, right?
Yeah, definitely.
So excuse me, sir.
So that truss we are saying as a cantilever truss, just like a beam. So we are supporting that truss along the vertical wall.
But vertical wall should have, see, you should have a, if you are defining that as a cantilever truss, fine.
Yeah.
You should have a pin here and you should have a roller one end.
Yeah.
You can't have anything more, you know, other than that.
Yeah, definitely.
If you just make a pin, then that's unstable. But you do have a roller, no? That will balance the force.
Yeah.
Is that clear?
Yeah.
Okay? Okay?
Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
The moment will be shifting this right support to below point B, it will be stable.
Huh. That you can, which one?
The yeah. Roller, if the roller is shifted to below B, that is just left of that.
Yeah.
And the truss will be stable, na?
Here.
Yeah.
If we move it.
In case the situation will be like this, in that condition,
it is a possibility, yes, because in that case it will be able to take the load.
Yeah,
yes.
Thank you.
Yes. So, okay, that was.
So, change the direction of last P in vertical direction
and
cut the suction at whatever it cut BC. In that case, it will satisfy the.
That may.
Yeah.
That may. But see, what I'm. The, yeah.
You are telling that whatever is the force, irrespective of force, it should be a stable. Now, you are putting the force downward.
Downward.
If it was initially upward, then you have to check the by taking the forces in both directions.
You can check because when you design a truss,
yeah.
I have to make sure that truss is properly stable under all combinations of loading. Right?
Okay, now,
Now
it is by chance here force is downward P.
Yes.
If it was the
upward P,
upward direction, then we have said it is okay.
It is okay. It is okay under that particular loading.
That particular loading. That means for total to check the assembly, you have to change the direction of.
You have to. If it is not given in the problem, you have to also make sure checking all the nitty gritty. We have to make sure that it is a properly stable truss. Okay, it is not a simple analysis, but what I am giving here, just given type of loading is given, let's say. If for that we can at least claim that it is not stable, then it's fine. Okay. So at least we are checking for one load combination that is not valid. Huh? Any other questions? Okay. So this one quickly. It was a very similar problem we have done actually. First, just count M plus R equals to 2N if that is valid or not, first of all. That is okay. Now, can we identify the simple truss here, please? So, ADFG is a, ADGF is a simple truss. If you really take a method of section, if we apply through DE and GH, right? So, that side is a properly constrained truss because it has a pin connection and it has a roller and looks like all the force can be balanced there, okay? Now we are again concerned about the right hand side of it, GH. So will it be balanced under any combination of loading? Just don't look at the combination I gave because in this case at least we have sorted out that one part of it is a simple truss and it is going to be stable under any kind of loading. So I am now just concerned about this particular member EH and the connections it is getting from the surroundings, right? So is that going to be always stable or not? It is going to be always stable. You can try to figure out if one member on the top goes under tension, the other member on the bottom will be under compression. So that will balance the moment all the time, balance the horizontal reaction all the time. Does not matter how I apply the roller, right? Clear? Okay. So that member EH will always be, will have a couple acting on it. That two member will act as a couple, right? But that will be balanced against the forces that is being acting on that particular member. Okay, there was a quiz problem also towards the end. This one is very interesting. You are not doing quiz now, but let's say, how about this one? So right side, yeah, both are pin connections here. Both has pins here. Just, again, you can try to think of, method of section we can apply actually. Anyway, how many are improperly constrained? Just raise hands, maybe. Is it really difficult? I mean, can we do a method of section here quickly, please? Can you tell me which portion is a simple truss? Which portion is a simple truss, internally rigid? Isn't that this portion, right? So I will definitely cut this truss. This is also a basic triangular truss, right? This is a basic truss. So what can happen if I really cut this right here? I'm just supposed to get the force here. What is this force going to act? Sure. Zero tensile compressive, I'm getting all sorts of answer. That can't happen. Just do join. This is going to be a? It is going to be compressive. So what happens now? You can clearly see now it is going to be compressive, right? So therefore, I will now put this force simple right here like this towards the joint, right? And I will take a moment about again left end. What happens? Unstable. It can rotate about that point, right? Therefore, it's a improperly constrained. Okay? Thank you.